Hello guys, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to make focaccia, but it's a very regional focaccia. It's a focaccia that comes from a city of Italy, which is Bari, and that is why it is called Bari focaccia. This focaccia is greatly served with soup and can be enjoyed throughout the day as a snack, and is wonderful cut into wedges and packed for picnic. So without further delay, let's start making this amazing focaccia bread. So yes, you have to start with the normal bread procedure, that is to activate yeast using sugar and lukewarm water. So that's what we are doing here. So once your yeast is activated, we will go to kneading the dough. So for this dough, I am not using mashed potatoes, but I am using all-purpose flour and semolina for this, so which will give a crispy texture. We will also use some tomatoes and olives and olive oil, of course. So yes, that's the ingredients. So let's start with kneading the dough for the focaccia. So if you have KitchenAid, it will reduce the amount of time, but if you are doing it with hand, make sure you knead it properly for at least 10 to 20 minutes. So in the dough, in the flour, make a well and add your yeast and lukewarm water and start kneading the dough slowly. So once you are done kneading the dough, place the dough in warm temperatures and give it time for at least 1 or 2 hours to rise. So once you give the time for the flour to rise, it will develop gluten and your focaccia will be fluffy and crunchy. So I will lightly oil my dough before I keep it for resting. So once I keep it for resting, and I'll take it out again after 2 hours, before I start working on my dough, I'll make sure my oven is preheated at 450 degree Fahrenheit, and then when I'm working on the dough and giving the shape to the bread, my oven is preheated and ready to put the bread inside. Lightly oil your pan in which you are going to make the focaccia and press your fingers over the top of the dough to create a dimple. So I have used olive oil so that the dough will have that flavor of olive oil. So if you want, you can place the olive oils in tomatoes. I am simply going to use tomato sauce here. So the tomato sauce is homemade pizza sauce that I use. So I've made that pizza sauce and I'll cover my bread with that. Now once your bread is ready, drizzle some little bit of olive oil on the top of it and put it in oven and bake it for 30 minutes, and then let it cool for 20 to 25 minutes and let it come to room temperature before slicing it, and that's when you can start enjoying your bread. This focaccia can be preserved for a couple of days if you wrap it properly and freeze it. You can take it with you while traveling. So yes, it's a good snack and it gives amazing taste. So do try this recipe at home and let us know what was your experience with it. It's quite easy to make and very fulfilling and very flavorful dish. So do try it and let us know in the comment section below. Bye bye, have a great day.